Hello, this is Dr. Otis Brawley, Chief Medical Officer of the American Cancer Society. As you probably heard, the Society recently released two of its signature scientific publications, Cancer Facts and Figures and the Cancer Statistics article. These publications provide a concise summary of important cancer statistics in a consumer-friendly format. These articles are also useful resources to all Society staff. This presentation highlights some of the important information in this year's Cancer Facts and Figures and the Cancer Statistics publication. Let's start with death rates, really the best way to measure progress against cancer. Unlike incidence, which can be affected by things like screening rates, cancer death rates truly reflect the impact of things like prevention, early detection, and improvements in treatment. Overall, cancer is the number two leading cause of death in the United States, second only to heart disease. Cancer accounts for nearly one quarter of deaths in the United States. In 2006, the latest year for which we have data, there were almost 560,000 cancer deaths in the United States. In 2009, it is estimated that more than 292,000 men and almost 270,000 women will die from cancer. Lung cancer is by far the most common fatal cancer in men and women. In men, lung is followed by prostate and colorectal cancer. In women, lung is followed by breast and colorectal cancer as the top causes of cancer death. The good news is that cancer death rates have been declining since the early 1990s in both men and women. Compared to the peak rates in the early 90s, the cancer death rate for all sites combined in 2005 was 19.2% lower in men and 11.4% lower in women. Steeper drops in men are due primarily to historical differences in smoking patterns between men and women. So, which cancers are driving this dramatic progress against cancer death? In men, about 40% of the overall decrease in cancer death rates are due to drops in lung cancer mortality since 1991. Death rates for prostate cancer have also been declining steeply, in part due to improvements in treatment. Colorectal cancer deaths in men are also down dramatically due to both early detection and the better treatments. Stomach cancer mortality has been dropping in the U.S. since the 1930s, due in part to the advent of refrigeration. Stomach cancer is still a major killer in non-industrialized countries. In women, breast cancer death rates changed little between 1930 and 1990, but decreased 27% between 1990 and 2005, due again to early detection using mammography and better treatments. Colon cancer death rates have been decreasing among women for more than 50 years. Also, death rates for stomach and uterine cancer have decreased steadily since 1930. This is a new calculation our epidemiologists began doing a couple of years ago. We looked at how many deaths have been avoided or delayed since death rates began dropping. We conclude that more than 650,000 cancer deaths that would have occurred had we not turned the corner in the early 1990s have been averted. However, there is still work to be done. While cancer death rates are dropping among all races, they continue to be higher in African Americans compared to whites. Importantly, though, progress is being made. Since 1996, the decline in death rates has been steeper in African Americans, among whom rates are dropping 2.5% per year, than for white men, for whom death rates are dropping about 1.6% per year. Now we turn our attention to cancer incidence. It is estimated that about 1.5 million new cases of cancer will be diagnosed in 2009. A little over half of those, 766,000, will be in men. Cancers of the prostate, lung, and colon will be the most frequently diagnosed cancers in men. In women, breast, lung, and colon cancers will be the most common types. You'll notice while lung cancer is the top cause of cancer death, it is number two in both men and women as far as incidence. But the good news was reported this year. Cancer incidence is declining for all cancers combined in both men and women. This slide shows that overall cancer incidence declined by 1.8% per year from 2001 through 2005 in men and by 0.6% per year from 1998 through 2005 in women. By the way, the peak in incidence in the early 1990s in men is due to the widespread use of PSA screening tests, which detected many cases of prostate cancer. In men, the incidence of prostate, lung, and colon cancers have declined in recent years. Again, you can clearly see the peak in the early 1990s when PSA began to be used fairly routinely. A reminder that the American Cancer Society does not recommend routine screening for prostate cancer, as it is still questionable as to whether it reduces mortality. Lung cancer rates are dropping thanks to less smoking, and colon cancer rates are dropping as more people get colon cancer tests and have polyps removed before they turn cancerous. In women, incidence of breast and colorectal cancers have declined. For colorectal cancers, that's because of polyps being removed before they become cancerous. Breast cancer rates are dropping, probably due to a combination of less postmenopausal hormone use, which raises the risk of breast cancer, and a slight drop in mammography utilization, which may delay the diagnosis of some tumors. Lung cancer rates, which increased steadily prior to 1991, have begun to level off. In men, cancer incidence rates are consistently higher in African-American men compared to white men. In contrast, incidence rates are generally lower in African-American women compared to white women, although the difference is not great. But even among men, you can see the gap is closing. Another sign of progress. Overall cancer survival rates have improved significantly, from about 50% in the 1970s to 66% in recent years. This is due in part to both earlier detection and advances in treatment. Thank you for your attention to these important findings. The American Cancer Society is saving lives by helping people stay well, helping people get well, by finding cures, and by fighting back against cancer. Cancer Facts and Figures documents the progress that has been made toward creating a world with more birthdays.